this is
New London, week three.
And a repeat of last week's first.
Yeah.
Already.
Bowser versus Sora.
Let's see. They are exactly like last saga at first.
I mean, that's just Sora.
It's Sora, so like Fyraga. Not keep Fyraga going. Could have.
Counter off.
Probably trying to shuffle through the fight.
Be on Thunder, I guess.
Thunder could be good for kind of about it.
Good for ledge and killing, but yeah. That's like it. Definitely not Bowser kill percent quite. Not going for aggressive plays. So good though.
We're good. Nintendo servers are looking fine right now.
As per usual.
We'll roll around F Smash. Yeah. That is true. Bowser, so I don't. The Bazaga. Happen here, neutral. Not much really happened. My opinion, my bold opinion.
It is a Thor versus a Bowser.
That is true. And the F2 will get the kill.
2 minutes in, only one stock has been taken each.
There are the sounds. And I just lied. We have sound. Oh, no.
No.
No. Yeah.
Intermission, yeah.
Alright.
Alright.
Forward air from the Sora. Bowser does a down air back to stage. Sora tries to up B to counter that down air. Throwing away the Fyraga, getting a forward air. No, that was Nair.
Yeah, it's the three hit is always Nair.
Forward air was also hit, but the kill.
Yeah, but like it always just works better with Nair.
Yeah, that's fair. The dash attack from Sora. F tilt from Bowser, not quite killing though. Neutral B. Sora countering for some random reason. Only using one Fyraga at a time. I could not tell you why. It's Fyraga, that's probably. And parrying the F smash, not quite a kill though. Still pretty. Ooh, countering.
If that downer did hit, then it would have killed probably.
That would have killed. No. Oh.
That.
Maybe.
Wait, hold on.
Not quite yet.
Side B didn't kill. Sora hit the side B.
The Sora hit their side B, though. Again, still only using one Fyraga at a time. Don't know why. Could not tell you why. And F tilt, again, getting a kill. We have 3 minutes.
50%. Sora's at zero. Both on last stock.
With 3 minutes and a few seconds to spare.
Just three minutes to spare.
Yeah. I did not know Blizzaga just deleted shield that much.
Yeah, that's like one of its few uses at low percents.
Trying to get a Thunder kill from, or Thundaga kill from the Sora. A neutral B, a B out of shield would have worked for the Bowser. A higher recovery to probably dodge that Blizzaga. Oh, the canceling, canceled it, I think. Okay.
Sora hit down
there. Sora got hit there, Donna, and Thundaga will get that.
Right. Well,
1-0 in New London's favor as of right now. So,
hopefully Nintendo servers work this time.
They probably will. It's just going to... I really think it'd be funny if it's, like, every time... Okay. Every first game it's going to kick us out, we're going to keep that ritual up. That'd be really funny. Yeah, but
just throughout the season.
That Sora did use Fyraga only a couple times and only doing one at a time. That is easily one of the most spammable moves in this game. That is one thing that thing did. And yeah, the neutral B used from the Sora was, I'd say it was okay. The Bowser did know how to get around it though with shields. The Zaga
didn't really shield the side Bs that were coming out either.
That's also true. Those are kind of harder. Well, I would say they're harder. They're not really harder to do. Like, you just
if
hold
you
it.
See the reticle, then you just
then
hold
you
shield.
Just hold shield, yeah. And then the Sora would always just up be the Bowser's down air.
Mm-hmm.
That would always work too. And then also, I think every time they did a counter was always on that right side, and they'd fall through that platform.
Yeah.
Probably trying to read either a down air.
Probably.
Or a landing aerial, I'd say. That's what I'd think was kind of going on there. And the Bowser did use side B fairly well, I'd say. There were a couple misses here and there, but still, that was, I'd say, was okay.
Hitting most of them. That
yeah. Yeah, so...
What stage do you think we'll get next?
I don't know. It's Sora? But the way that they were playing Sora is throwing me off. I would say Kalos for average Sora, but that's not an average Sora. I'd probably say, like, Smashville. So, that's just my guess. Is I like Smashville or Town?
Bastion or PS2.
I wouldn't say Hollow Bastion. They really did not use projectiles that much and used platforms to their advantage. So... It is PS2. Good map choice. Easily the best one. No ifs, ands, or buts about it. Once again, starting off with Neutral B. Fyraga. Again, the roll around, getting the grab, not doing much of the roll after the F smash. Scared there. Parrying the F tilt. That one, the side B. Something? Nope. Saga, once again. Almost. That would have breached. That would have broken, I think.
Maybe.
The parry? Okay. Up B out of shield.
Yeah.
There's the usual Bowser. There's the.
And that was a really good F tilt.
That was really good. Again, only using one Fyraga. Yeah. Could be to try and stop something at ledge.
Probably just
also another
regular
thing.
Get up or get up.
Thundaga not quite getting the reach. That's good. Yeah, that shield poke. Shockwave hit from the down air.
Again
with the... Didn't quite get the jump so that it...
And
the
kill.
Downer will get the kill. Two at a time. Smash. Again, rolling after every F smash for some reason.
I mean, that's...
option?
Yeah.
The thunder. Getting
Downer hits with the shockwave again.
Poke? No, shock. Think,
yeah, shockwave.
Shockwave, but
shockwave with the roll.
Yeah, that was probably not doing anything after the up throw. Parrying a random hit from up B. I mean, like,
okay,
you do you, I guess. F tilt once again. Thunder. Nothing happened though.
Zaga,
again,
didn't
Blazaga.
Really do anything.
Blazaga, who, whoa, Blazaga doing something? Oh,
nope.
The side B to
get
catch the
up.
Roll.
Yeah. Air dodge
through the down air, but that's fine because we have an F tilt. Neutral B. Cab's not quite gonna do it fast enough. Down air.
Down air.
The kill. That's another one. And F smash and hitting that roll.
Well, about. Single Fireaga actually did something, I guess.
Shielding the Thundaga. Time to do that.
Down air.
Down air. The parry. Oh my god, what's up with random parrying today? Up B, the down air, once again. Trying to hit the up B. Built, but it was the wrong way. That second, or F smash will get that kill.
Still two stocks to one with Bowser.
Yeah. 39% on the sword.
Still this looking is, very good for us.
It is. Good.
Yep.
It'll be not fast enough, though.
I think that's our first, like, regular grab we've seen all game.
Yeah. Thundaga still not doing it, because Bowser.
Yeah.
I'd be there. Spot dodging. Dash attack. Blizzaga. F smash. F smash again.
Yep. And punish. Not quite getting a kill.
Not quite getting a kill, but it's 88% is close. Back air. Get the kill. And that is 1-1 for the first game.
Right.
This is
first round goes to game three.
This is scarily close, and I do not like it. Although it's not really that scarily close, in my bold opinion. Oh, my oh so bold opinion.
I mean, that last game was two stock.
That was a two stock game, and I was going to say we're doing really good that game, but knowing me, I would have gotten the commentator's curse on that one, so I refrained from saying something.
But then you said it anyway.
Well, that's post-match, so it doesn't count. We're not in a match, it doesn't count. Unless it does. And then I'm going to sit here and think about my actions of why I said something. So, again, I don't know what happened that game, but that Bowser just
did what he needed to do.
Did what it had to do. The uppies out of shield were good. The side B's to catch the roll after every F smash was also really good.
And the Nair punish with F tilt, like, early on, that was just, like, really good.
That was also really good, too. But was every... No, every kill wasn't with down air. It was down air, and F smash? Back air. It was a kick. Kick of some sort, so... That was still a pretty good game, though. Maybe we could see a repeat of that one. Third game?
If they say.
I feel like they would. It was a really good, strong first game.
Yeah, I think because of that first game.
Because of that first game, they might stay Sora, but I also wouldn't be surprised to see a character switch.
Yeah.
That is something I wouldn't really expect to see, but still it wouldn't surprise me.
And if stage.
If there was a character switch, I don't know if there would be a character switch.
I mean, if there's a character switch, you don't really know who, what stage it would be.
That is also true. So, like, if they do stay Sora, I feel like they might... Again...
They might try and run it back to Battlefield.
Yeah, the platforms did work very well in their favor, so I'd say either Town and City... Again, Town and City or Smashville, maybe a Hollow Bastion...
Maybe, just because of that center platform,
that could help just enough. Because with PS2, Pokemon Stadium 2,
a lot of interactions were...
But they were kind of in that middle or above the platforms. Yeah. There was nothing where it was Sora below, Bowser above on a platform. So.
And that's like where Sora would want to be.
That Sora would, yeah. So... If they do stay Sora, which I'm going to assume they would, I'd assume they'd probably go for a stage with a good amount of platforms, like Smashville, or Hollow Bastion with that big one in the center, just to kind of have that only
actionable space for that Bowser to be at the ledges, which then Sora could take advantage of and just launch them off because of Bowser's recovery. So, or at least that's just my thought process if I was the Sora. That's what I would be thinking. So, I don't know if that's the case, but hey, we'll see. We'll see if Smashville, Town City, or Hollow are going to be it.
Mm-hmm.
I have my vote on one of them. I don't know what one, but one of them.
I mean, they're a Sora, so I'm just going to go Hollow Bastion. Just Sora's home stage.
Hold on here. We have a reskin counter pick.
Oh, Town and City. Yep, Town City.
It is Town and City. All right. They're going to try and get the lower height advantage. Opponents.
And we can see that a little bit there, although it didn't really
and
work out.
And there's
too
just
well.
A wayward F smash.
But hey, it works.
It works. Again, throwing away the Firagas or just not knowing that you can.
I feel like at this point.
No.
Oh.
So early. Why? Okay.
Well, like I was saying, I think at this point, because we haven't seen any second Firagas, I think they just don't know.
I don't know about that one. I think they know about this. I feel like they know about it. A forwarder being countered. Only one Firaga again. F tilt, not quite getting the kill, but close.
Sora's at almost 150 right now.
Yeah.
Thundaga through the stage.
That is something I have not seen a Sora do, like, ever, actually. I don't think I've ever seen a Sora do that.
I haven't either, and I used to play Sora.
F-tilt, not quite getting the kill because of the roll around, and F-smash gets the kill for the Sora. Again, shielding all the hits of Thundaga.
Up out of shield, didn't connect. And then
an instant break out of Blizzaga, what the heck?
This is so low percent.
Yeah, that makes sense.
I think like any move from Bowser would probably kill.
Any
Sora
move from Bowser will probably work.
Except maybe Uppie.
Yeah, I was gonna say Uppie's probably gonna be the one that won't work. One Blizzard or Firaga, and F tilt gets the kill for the Bowser.
But Bowser is at 80.
Bowser is at 80%.
Although to be fair, that's not kill percent. Anymore.
That is not anywhere close to kill percent, especially with a Bowser against the Sora. Yeah. Missing, only getting one hit of Nair, missing the other two, and the Bowser got an F smash, or an F tilt with that one. Catching the shield with side B, up B not quite hitting, the down air from the Sora to counter their up B, F smash. Again, the roll around. Trying to get the Thundaga out, but because it's Town and City in the high ceiling, it's not gonna really do much. Again, missing that Blizzaga, only one hit of Firaga. Thundaga, again, not getting the kill because of that ceiling. Sora crouching there, probably to get the counter out, but it didn't quite work.
Counter,
and didn't
down
get
smash, actually.
Well, if you're holding down, it would only be down tilt, not down smash. Oh, trying to hit an up air, but the Sora down air, taking the stock from the Bowser. F tilt from the Bowser. Didn't hold the Bowser, not holding the neutral B out.
I feel like that would definitely have been a multiple Firaga situation if they
got
it. The main players almost had a disconnect. But
and there's the shield break from. And Bowser's out of the shield break. Oh, I love this game. Maybe. What are we going to see? Nair. Okay, shield the first hit. Down air, not quite killing because of the ceiling with a voice crack. Very subtle, but it was there. And the F smash. And because of how long the startup was, it got around that counter. Both players on their last stock, Bowser only at 30%. This. Yeah. Throw. to up air, or up throw up air. Trying to get the side B for the Bowser. Or Bowser trying to get the side B.
There's so much lag.
There is so much lag. Air dodging through the Thundaga.
Every time it pauses, I am terrified.
I'm terrified too.
Bowser's at 100, Sora's at 0. Oh,
but
never mind. Sora's at 20.
Not anymore. The F tilt being fast enough to catch the roll. Because the Sora's F smash to roll. Funny little mechanic there. Neutral B.
Like 30%-ish.
That's still 30%.
Yeah.
Closing in on kill percent for Bowser if cards are played correctly. Forward air. Maybe we could see something here. And not quite. The Bowser probably trying to get an air dodge or a parry with countering
really
with
close game.
Sword did get the F smash though because of a mistimed shield.
Alright, well, my turn.
Or shield cancel. Alright, well, you have fun. Would someone like to join the booth? Come on. We have a friend. All right, and it's the Bowser from last game. How do you think that went, your opinion?
Not good, really.
No, I'd say quite the opposite. You guys are kind of at a close skill gap.
Are you playing your normal?
Losing the first game, but the winning the second one, but the last game was pretty close. That was not bad at all.
Improvement from the first time I played Sora, at least.
Yeah, because it was rough last week, but I don't know what it was in that second game, but a switch just turned on for you, and you just started destroying the Sora.
Yeah,
I don't know what it was. I could not tell you what it was. Were you just more focused? What were you?
Got advice from someone that got tips.
Yeah, that'd do it. That would work.
I just gotta try executing more, though.
Because you did, there were a couple times where you did do pretty well, because that Sora would always F smash and then roll behind you. There were a couple times where you did get kills off of that. Either kills or really good punishes with it. So that was one thing, like one of the first things I've noticed with that Sora. And I think over time you started to notice that too, and that's kind of how you started getting that upper edge of that Sora. So, I don't know if you want to add on to anything or.
Let's have to work on it for next time if I go up against another Sora.
It would be very funny if you had a Sora next week. That would be very, very funny. Yeah, and our next person up, I don't know who we're playing against, what character they play. If you had any guesses, what would your guess be?
I'm going to say Donkey Kong.
That is kind of out there, but honestly, I think that I could see that happening. Okay, so we have another person who was willing to join the booth after their match is over.
But anyway,
lost my train of thought. You said Donkey Kong, right?
Yeah.
I think about this like they know our character. They don't know what character we are playing, and I need to. And so everyone on the roster is there and is equal chance of happening. I would say a sortie. I don't think it's going to be a sortie.
Well, we know they don't want Town and City and Small Battlefield, just so you know.
So they don't
want. So when you ban your next two,
okay.
Leave them with the ones they don't want. That's because they're me, right?
I mean,
I'm just gonna say it's not a sortie. I don't know who else, who to pick that isn't a sortie. I'm just, I just don't think a sortie is gonna happen. At least not this first game. But based off how the first game goes, they might switch to a sortie. Because of,
yeah.
Just to kind of like get that range, like some amount of range in. Because if it's a rushdown character, those have a 50-50 chance of working. With it being either so close ranged and a projectile would be, I think not every character has a projectile, but almost everyone does. So, not a sortie. I feel like it might be a rushdown. I feel like a rushdown, like a close range character. That's what I'm thinking. I think it's going to be a close range character, a rushdown close range character. That's my guess.
That makes sense.
So, yeah. And we are just about getting started. That does not work. Who do we have today? Aegis against a Wario. Okay, so I was on the spot with a close range character. Wario having rather stubbier hitboxes, having to get really close. Like Aegis, it's going to be a tough challenge. The side B. Little too far forward. Side B again. Run up neutral B. Only the first hit hitting. And that's a zero to death. Only the first hit really. There's the Wario. Kind of starting, but still. Good at outspacing. Also working really well with this. Side B's are what's, and it's actually working really well. Kind of staying good distance away so that Mario can't. Most to all attacks, and what say sweet spots? I don't really have any good sweet spots. Up B, not quite killing. It was very close though, and the neutral B to read the ledge to stop the ledge get up. Just not quite working, but there's side B. Ira, sorry. Dash attack, probably dash in. The side, but they work, that's the thing. There's the Wario. Wario with Waft fully charged. Careful with that. And Wario is able to recover, but they were on the ledge for too long. Staying on that ledge for too long, side B being able to hit, still is charged. As you can tell with Wario being. And F smash does get the kill, but Waft doesn't go away with Wario, so charging hitbox. Wario's bike. Up B, getting Wario on the platform. That one, because correctly it could kill. And dash attack does get the kill. And right as we, that is the lucky spot to be kicked out of the server. That is the luckiest spot to get kicked out of the server. But the dash attack does get it because there was no tech option that I saw anyway. They just let it happen. Wasn't a tech. If there was a tech, that it could have been a shield roll, which I think any tech option would have. Any tech option would have beaten that dash attack. Mario just doesn't work in this matchup as that distance, like just enough distance out of range of still get those hits in and like the side B of Pyro being able to stop ledge stalling. At all, which I'm surprised about. Waft is Mario's best move, especially when fully charged. Which is also, like, it's really a good offensive move, but it's also a good recovery tool if fully charged. Higher than his up B. And they just stay Wario. They stayed Wario. But it is on Battlefield, so this. Like, maybe could be stall on the platforms. Reels. Mario. Not quite hitting, but the at ledge side B does get a couple hits in. Nair just barely hitting from the Wario. Double Nair hit. Other side. Side B. Running away from the side B, but lightning neutral B does indeed get the kill.
That's a quick.
That is a rather quick first stock. The dash attack. Rather impressive. Eating bike. And now. Again, Wario's stubby hitboxes with the down tilt. And I think. At all. The turnaround neutral B. I don't know if like a Wario would be a pocket pick and they're just. But. Pocket pick, then they would have switched their main. So if. Breaking Wario's bike, so he can't. And up B does. Get that kill. Okay. Well, that was something. That was a lot of something. All right, we have a 3-person commentator booth. That was a very weird Wario. I was surprised to not see a character switch. With how stubby Wario's hitboxes are, they tried to poke with down tilt at ledge at one point, but what? Step back. Okay, and yeah, that was just a weird Wario because, like, at ledge, you're the Mithra neutral B was spaced just enough so that the Wario down tilt just couldn't hit because Wario's hitboxes are just too stubby in that battle. I don't.
Yeah, and I don't think they knew how to play against an Aegis either.
That could be it, because they were just standing there as you were charging neutral B, probably not expecting you to being able to turn it around.
Yeah. expecting the back head box either. Like, I could have just done that.
But you'd still expect him to at least pull an attack off.
I feel like they would have at least done something. Yeah. Or at least they know that the back hitbox, because, again, like I said, Wario's hitbox is being so stubby. Mm-hmm. If they ran in to try and do something, they would have just been hit by it. So that could have been it, too.
Close enough for the back hitbox to
Switch,
hit.
Did you do that already?
Yeah.
Yes.
Okay. Huh?
They were close enough for the back hitbox to still hit.
Oh. Okay. Never mind. So, I don't know. I don't know what they could have done then. Because if you're charging it, they can't do anything above you. And by the time they were behind you, you already let it go, so they...
I mean, they could have wafted.
Yeah, they didn't use waft that entire time. It was fully charged for, like, the last two stocks, and they just didn't use it. I don't know why, because it's really good offensively, and it's also a good recovery tool, because it's higher than that up B.
Even, so, like, there were a couple situations where it was fully charged, and it would have let them get back to stage.
Yeah. I don't know why they didn't use it. At all, but...
Plus, like, when I was just trapping them with Pyro Side B, like, they could have done that and gotten above it.
Mm-hmm. And they just...
They didn't.
They just didn't, and they also just kept going... I was about to say they kept going back to Ledge, like, the only option Wario kind of has.
Yeah.
Which is why Pyro Side B is just so good at canceling that, because it's... They don't get iframes for Ledge re-grabs. So I don't know.
Yeah. Hmm? Who do you guys think they're gonna pick?
I don't know. I got my rushdown pick. Well, my close range rushdown pick. So I think I'm done for the season. I'm guessing characters.
I don't know. I'm just gonna throw out a random Byleth.
It's gonna be like Mario or something.
You know, we're gonna double dip. I'm gonna say it's gonna be another rushdown close range character.
Right.
That's my guess. We're gonna do a double or nothing
on
this
one.
Now
it's gonna be like a Mega Man.
Now it's gonna be like a Mega Man or like a really like a really spammy character. That's most likely what it'll be.
Definitely gonna be like a Sonic or something.
If it's a Sonic, it's
Mewtwo.
Not a Sonic. It is Mewtwo. That is a rather strange works. I could too, yeah. Dash attack coming up. A follow up with the dash attack, rolling away from. And that is
right.
Okay. Well, early stock.
No, that constitutes a blue button.
That does constitute a blue button. That is very good. That does constitute a blue button. I don't think this is a thing styled Mewtwo.
Yeah.
That's
against him. Against.
Yeah, that's not gonna work against. Again, just like standing at ledge.
Something with the internet.
Yeah, there might be something going on.
Okay, they're like.
Oh, never mind. They're back. Right. Maybe.
They attacked. Yeah. Has to be something with.
Yeah, I was gonna say. Oh well, our internet cut out as they want.
Of course. Again.
Again. A good time to quit out though. I don't know if that Mewtwo was just like needing a breather or something. Why else would they have ran to ledge like that? Like, out of nowhere, they just ran to ledge, so I don't know
if
something was needing to happen on their end. So we got word of their controller just...
It looked like...
So their controller disconnected, so we're just doing a playback, because... Gonna be the same thing. So weird though. I don't know how that happens. That
Well, they were doing really good. A random F smash? No, side B, F smash? Oh.
Mewtwo side B is good again.
Positioning.
Yeah.
Not quite getting a... For Mewtwo. Got the psychic. And F smash will get that Mewtwo out of there. Bit on the button presses, but... There's the thing. But to do an attack, countering the neutral beat. Realized the AO punch was coming out, so they...
I think they just rolled away.
Rolled away. That would make more sense than an air dodge. Grab.
Connected.
The counter to... And the upbeat does get the kill, and it was close enough to the ledge where they were... I don't know why they're just rolling. Probably expecting, like, a run-up.
I mean, even then, like...
Spot dodging would be better. And
failed uppy.
Yeah. That's... But what's the...
Yeah, what's the orange?
All right, the orange one. This will be winning. That's a stock. That's... Game, stock,
anything
oof.
Weird.
Yeah. Okay, so... Again, that Mewtwo wasn't playing as campy as they definitely could have.
And as they should have.
As they should have against Little Mac. Yeah, definitely. I don't... And then, even when they did shoot the Shadow Balls... I think that's Shadow Ball.
Yeah.
Yeah, Shadow Ball. Little Mac just countered it.
Yeah.
And the worst part was it worked. That's the saddening part.
Like, they released it, like, so close to Mac.
So close to Mac, so where it just hits.
Yeah.
I don't know why, but it happened, so do we want to, yeah. Do you want to move this back then?
I think Kelton
wants to
join once he got back.
Yeah, once he's done, Kelton wants to join. But, yeah, I don't know. Like, if you're shooting a projectile, I'd expect you to be far enough away so that even if it is countered, it wouldn't hit. Like, it would only hit you if reflected, not countered. So I don't know what was happening there. Not zoning, but... And the... Side B 2, the side B F smash wasn't true except for the one time where Mac tried to counter it with, I think, they tried a jab, but since they were in the air, it was a neutral air.
Yeah.
So that's why that F smash hit. And we're going to see what's going to go on here. Are you expecting, I'm expecting a character switch from the Mewtwo. That would make sense.
That would make sense, but I don't know if they'll do it.
They haven't done it when it would have been good the last couple of times against the characters.
Yeah,
not a switch from the Mewtwo, but a switch from the Little Mac to Ganondorf.
Right?
I guess they just want to get... I guess
just
the Ganondorf just wants
faster,
to get this done and over with. They don't want to deal with it anymore. And Ganondorf being Ganondorf, 51% after about 5 moves.
And...
Almost dead already. Trying to go for a down air, too. I would say it was a tech. So, right, they just didn't really... And down B still being able to...
Parry the Shadow Ball.
No, it was parry the get up attack, but whiffed the F smash. Was able to recover.
And
up air does get the kill. This is peak Ganondorf gameplay of just throw moves out there, because what can they do?
Yeah.
And
Shadow Ball not quite getting the kill. I'd expect another one, though.
Yeah,
not probably. Another Shadow Ball. Okay, they had it fully charged. There's the other Shadow Ball. And back throw does take that stock. Okay. Air. I've barely ever seen a Ganondorf.
One of the faster moves, I think.
Why don't they just, like, use... It's not,
I mean,
like,
back air is faster.
And tried to down B, but Ganondorf was in the air. So it did absolutely nothing.
And Aqua's taken.
There it is.
Shield break didn't take.
There we go. Fuck that we missed. Trying to get the down B, I'm assuming down B Shadow Ball. The dash attack up air.
Disable also does do a lot of shield damage if it actually hits.
That is also true. And parrying that Shadow Ball.
Parried dash attack.
Oh my. No, they parried the Shadow Ball.
Parry into dash attack.
Oh, okay. Forward air
jump
once again.
Just
jumps over
air.
The Shadow Ball. Up smash. Gets the kill. That was just Ganondorf.
That was just the game.
Ganondorf. I don't know what more there is to say. That was just Ganondorf. That was just Ganondorf. So
I've had no trauma yet.
That is 2-1 in Seymour's favor.
Well,
what was going on in your head when switching to Ganondorf?
I wanted to have fun.
Fair enough.
That is true. Because Little Mac is just a smash attack simulator. Ganondorf is just throw out whatever you feel like, because what are they going to do about it?
Exactly, and it worked.
It did work, but that's also because it's Mewtwo. What can Mewtwo do?
I mean, yeah.
Especially when you parry a fully charged Shadow Ball.
That time it was intentional.
Yeah.
Intentionally parrying. What a hot take.
Yeah.
What a hot take. Intentionally doing a parry? That's a hot take. No one intentionally parries. It just happens on accident, but you claim it happens.
Yes.
On purpose. That was a game. That was a set.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Little Mac. But they just didn't play Mewtwo the way that I was expecting them to play against a Little Mac.
Yeah, they really need to zone more.
They needed to zone.
Against either character.
Well, they did in against Ganondorf. They started using Shadow Ball a lot more.
And just didn't work.
Yeah.
That was too late.
Yeah. It was indeed too late. It was too late for them to do anything. So.
Listen, my parents want me to do this, but hi, Mom. Hi, Dad. Happy birthday, Mom.
Shouting out the parents. Bold move, but I like it. I respect it. We should go to gameplay now. And I think I saw
Incineroar.
An Incineroar.
Well, fire versus
fire. Yeah. We'll see how this goes. Incineroar
is slow
compared to Captain Falcon, who's the second fastest.
Yeah.
I'm also eager to see how many side Bs there are. And there it is! The zero to death from that Captain Falcon.
Very skillful.
Skillful, except it's Incineroar, so like if you get him 5 feet away from ledge, what can he do?
Yeah.
Nothing.
Exactly.
The Incineroar missed
and
earlier.
Knee.
Yeah.
Falling down knee. That was a... block didn't do at the percent of work.
Oh no, counter.
Oh, what are they gonna do next?
And
that's it. Yeah, there's the throw.
Yeah,
no more revenge. Okay, and down air, up air again.
And
oh no, there's the counter.
They missed
it again.
Flubbed it.
They goofed it up. Maybe we can see a grab. Not a grab.
Try it again, but it missed.
And the revenge went to forward air. And the forward throw, a forward throw does get that kill. And the down smash from Incineroar. Side B. And Captain Falcon's side B is better because Captain Falcon. I mean, there are a lot of down smashes and no other smash attack.
Yeah. Although that is a lot of Incineroar
they
too.
Haven't, I don't think they know how his side B works.
That was definitely an intentional shift to keep the Captain Falcon off stage.
I don't think the other two were, though.
And there it is. Because Incineroar. But with that last Alolan Whip, I think they intentionally didn't do anything about it because it would have kept that Captain Falcon off
that
stage.
That one I could see being intentional. I think the other two were not.
No.
Definitely not. And as a man who pockets Incineroar, I probably would have just done an Alolan Whip because I only pocket Incineroar.
But I've played with and against enough Incineroars to... I feel like that was an intentional miss on that last side B to keep the Captain Falcon off stage. Because Incineroar kind of tried to keep the stage control. Because I think...
That's kind of all you can do as Incineroar against a Falcon.
That is true, but one thing I didn't see a Darkest Lariat. That's also one of Incineroar's best neutral moves.
Yeah.
Like, a down tilt, full hop, neutral B with Incineroar is a good way to get kills out.
Plus it has some invincibility.
It does have some invincibility, and if the opponent holds the shield, Darkest Lariat just breaks it. So Darkest Lariat is a very good move, and they could have used that. They didn't, though. But...
So do you think we'll get a character switch?
I don't know.
No.
They haven't the last couple of times.
Yeah. I don't know.
So I don't see it this happening this time.
There might be a new...
Although, we're going to say no, and as we suspected...
It's Incineroar.
What stage, though?
They never learn.
I don't think we... I'm going to say Hollow.
Yeah, we might see a Hollow last.
And it's PS2. Good pick.
Who was Punk?
Here we go. Both starting...
He done three moves.
And got through
and
revenge.
Captain Falcon staying in the tech. And I don't think they know how to get that side B.
Or they might be trying, like, they're just really struggling.
Yeah.
That too. I think they could just be pressing it late.
They've been using...
Down smash, just...
Well, time to
over-exaggerate the commentary here. Up smash not hitting, but that was a good thing. There's the side B.
That one.
Down smash, and Falcon kick does get the kill to punish that down smash from... Incineroar really using revenge a lot. They really like using revenge, but
I think
honestly,
time to do like revenge Alolan Whip.
Yeah, like revenge is very good. It can be very good and very useful. Yeah. And the up B to counter the F smash.
Kind of predictable.
They're finally hitting the side Bs, so that's good.
The down smash.
Who would have?
To side B under down smash. That's something you don't see in any normal game.
Trying to kill off the top, it seems.
That's kind
of
mostly
back.
The best way to kill Incineroar.
I mean, in that situation where they were like...
And up smash to kill the Incineroar from our Captain Falcon. There's
the
Darkest Lariat. Again, going for revenge. But still, revenge is very good with... Revenge could be very useful in this matchup. And Darkest Lariat not quite getting the kill, though. A double jump for some reason. I would have expected a down air. And
Star KO.
And Star KO Simon. From Incineroar, early Incineroar side B.
Pretty even game.
This is really even. But Incineroar being at 60%, 70, 80, and rising. 90.
Incineroar's at 90.
Falcon's at 105. At and Falcon the nair from Captain Falcon right. gets that kill. Alright. You guys have fun. It's my turn.
Alright.
Kelton, you move up here.
Alright.
Ooh, yay.
No, I gotta make sense.
No, just move back here.
Come on, you can exist.
I don't want to exist.
Then you just move with that chair.
Do I have to?
No. You don't have to. But you can, if you want to.
I'll just exist right here.
Alright.
I did look up moves for you in case you didn't know. You can read them a little bit.
So, what character do you think we'll get?
I think I'll throw it out. Ice Climbers.
All right.
We have a true gamer.
No. What character do you think they'll pick?
They're gonna throw a curveball and go Princess Peach here.
Whoa.
Oh, man.
I feel like it'll be a Dedede for some reason.
Oh, Dedede?
Yeah.
Battlefield. And
I don't know why I feel like I just do.
Whatever be they do, they better choose
violence,
or else they will die.
We actually got the new
one.
Good job,
Sip.
What stages? What stage do you think we'll get on? PS2?
PS2.
Yeah.
Because who wouldn't?
I mean, most of people this round.
What's going to be Town City?
Everyone Maybe. Likes PS2 for some reason.
I feel like it'll be a small battlefield.
It'll be Palantina at Town
small
and City.
Small battlefield.
Oh my god.
Small battlefield, you said?
Yes.
Who do you think they're gonna play
as?
I don't know.
Link. Princess
Peach. Joker.
Alright.
You're all wrong horribly.
And let's see what stage it is. Switch gameplay.
Battlefield.
I was right on stage at least. Starting off with. Oh, and there's an electric wind god. Never remember Kazuya. Got the Tetric aren't off. Oh, and Joker died before getting our send. At 100 already.
Yeah, that's Kazuya for you.
Back. Back did. And they'll come
up. Nice.
Electric
violent too. Be a pretty
run button duty. Oh, comeback mechanic.
They're both probably not gonna be that late A for a long. As our son, Kazuya is
We haven't
Kazuya.
Seen Kazuya's comeback mm-hmm. mechanic. Oh, we
right,
did it for a second.
They have
yes,
chosen
smash.
Violence.
Ben's gone, but... to gun... Why they just... cage randomly? Because it works, but... Like,
why so. Not?
Oh. Nintendo,
no!
Nice. Alright, I'll get out of the way so you can over enthusiastically narrate what's happening.
And Kazuya just killed.
I guess that's enough of her enthusiastically there.
Gentlemen, be careful with the
nice. So do you think the Joker will switch?
No.
Yeah,
not a chance.
I don't think so either.
Switching is not a common New London theme.
No,
no. We're having new in their name. They don't like playing new characters.
I mean, at least all these characters were unique.
Yeah. I think they're gonna play Hollow Bastion.
Maybe.
Okay, I'm gonna say this again. Who picked Hollow Bastion?
I mean, the central platform is good.
No, but you just kind of say, out of all the stages, I want to play at Hollow Bastion.
Yeah. Out of the legal stages, it's...
Sarcasm, no, he doesn't.
It's gonna be like... Carlos.
Joker likes platforms. Mm-hmm. And Kazuya doesn't. So I think it's probably a good thing for them to do platforms.
Mm-hmm. Hope they ban Battlefield.
Yeah.
PS2 or Battlefield.
Oh, I'm expecting a Smash Bros.
The
actually, no, Town City.
Both?
I'm feeling a Town City here.
PS2 will stain Joker.
Strangely, both Smashville and Town City are very...
drastically different from Joker.
I mean, they might, but I doubt it.
Just, like, you'll get Joker, and then just, like, out of the blue, you get, like, Terry.
Did get the skin swap with the Sora.
Yeah. That was it. And that might have not been intentional because it's the skin right after.
You know, went from Sora to Ninjago to rip off Sora.
Imagine they have a secondary Kazuya. If they have a secondary Kazuya, that'd be absolutely.
For some reason, people don't like Smashville and Town City.
Probably just because the platform's moving. Yeah, I've had combos ruined by platforms moving.
Isn't it?
Then again, you're the one that has to fight me, so you're probably the one that has to deal with me surviving by those platforms.
I think it only happened twice.
I'm pretty sure it's actually the stage that moves and not the platforms. It just gives it an effect.
No, like the platforms move off the stage. Like it moves off the screen.
You guys all good for Monday or Tuesday next week competition?
Yep.
I'll still be here.
Probably.
Sick.
I don't have any reason not to be here.
Nope. If you can't, then email the address.
Being with Joker Kazuya.
Who would have thought? Joker.
And it's on Hollow Bastion.
Hey, I was right.
I thought they were gonna change
characters. No. Change characters all day. I mean, so far, yeah. Oh, I thought we disconnected in like 15 seconds, which would be a new world record.
That would be a record.
Ariel.
Already
oh, that's
has,
dead.
Oh.
No, it's not.
Almost
they
got the kill. Just
decided to be violent this time.
Tried to get a combo off the down tilt, but didn't quite get it.
Throw.
Oh. Kazuya's shield was getting low, and then he just died.
Counter.
Joker's really high percent right now, so probably gonna die pretty soon.
A lot of things could, but
yeah.
Unfortunately, Kazuya has so many options.
Yeah. And that's
that
gonna do it.
Kill.
100% 2-stock each. And Kazuya combos.
Kazuya. Got 95% off a combo. Kazuya.
Not even our Sen could suck Kazuya.
Kazuya finally did.